nurse who was accused of causing that fiery LA crash that killed 6 people last Thursday? Well, it turns out we have some shocking updates. Not only were there found to be no alcohol in her system, but also it turns out that she had 13 previous crashes. That's right. This is a picture of her here. This is 37-year-old Nicole Linton. She's a traveling registered nurse from Houston, and she was hit recently now with 6 counts of murder. She also faces 5 counts of vehicular manslaughter. The LA County DA again said there was no evidence of alcohol in her system, which countered an initial narrative that was offered by an unnamed woman claiming to be Linton's friend who was day drinking with her that day, allegedly. And we also know that now Linton is basically facing life in prison if she's convicted on all charges. So this per the Los Angeles Times. Los Angeles County Superior Court Judge Natalie Stone denied Linton bail, which previously had been set at $9 million at the request of the DA's office, which said she's a flight risk. Linton was set to leave LA and travel to Hawaii for work, prosecutors said. Prosecutors also said that they were reviewing multiple previous crashes linked to Linton, both in and out of California, including one in 2020 that involved bodily injury in which 2 cars were totaled. They provided few additional details. Now, it's also unclear whether Linton was ever criminally charged for any of those incidents. Her attorney said also that they're looking into her alleged history of documented profound mental health issues. But of course, the attorneys wouldn't elaborate there. Now, if you recall, as far as this accident goes, last Thursday, her Mercedes had plowed into traffic at a very busy intersection in Windsor Hills, bursting into flames upon colliding with multiple cars, setting at least 3 of them ablaze. Now, Linton was allegedly going 90 miles per hour in a 35 when she blew through a red light, hurling her Mercedes into a light pole. Now, the impact and resulting fire killed 23-year-old Asheray Ryan, her unborn child, 11-month-old son, Alonzo Quintero, her boyfriend, Reynold Lester, as well. Now, Ryan was 8.5 months pregnant and en route to a prenatal checkup. The unborn baby has been named Armani Lester, according to the coroner's office. But the unborn child couldn't be included in Linton's charges, as an unborn child is not considered a human being here in California. Now, there's a man also named Craig Pitchford, and here's his picture. He was identified by his family as the 4th victim in the crash. 2 additional women who were killed have yet to be identified. And in addition to the fatality, 6 children and 2 adults were also injured. There were a lot of people who were harmed by Linton's actions. Now, the photos also that were posted online of the crash show that Linton was on the curb with a bloody arm. She was hospitalized with moderate injuries for several days before she was taken into police custody, but clearly she survived this unscathed when you consider it in the context of people losing their lives. Again, 90 miles per hour reportedly in a 35, and the woman has 13 other crashes. Something is very wrong here. What do you think, AB?
Yeah, so first my heart goes out to the victims and their families, because I'm sure this is a very tough time for them. And this is very unfortunate. I'm really familiar with this area. And so one thing about it, especially if you're not from the Los Angeles area and have never traveled down this hill, it is a steep hill and you can excel pretty quickly. So you have to be very aware of your speed in this. One of the issues I have though is that we don't have a lot of information about the mental capacity, the mental impairments or anything of this defendant, right? At this time, we know she was a travel nurse, and we know that our nurses have been worked quite a bit throughout the pandemic and longer. And so I'm wondering, like, if there's any mental health issues, right? Any mental impairments, since we don't have any drugs or alcohol in her system. And one of the issues I did have though with the judge denying bail in this case is, like, she gave the example of, if she is a nurse, then she should understand any kind of medical issues she has or any medicine that she's using and the effects of that. And while that is so, I think sometimes we miscalculate how mental illness works, and we assume that the person is just as aware of their status or what they have going on when they're, you know, having a mental episode. So if this is the case, I really want to know more about why, you know, this seemingly you know, this woman who's a professional woman has, you know, decided to go 95 miles per hour down this steep cliff, or steep hill rather. And on top of that, you know, some people are just unlucky drivers, but I really want to know more about how these other accidents happened. Was she, you know, was she the person who was hit? Is she just an unlucky driver, or is she really a negligent driver and deserves to be in jail behind this? Now, I do think there's some accountability that needs to be held, but I'm still, you know, I think I'm just uneasy about the fact that we don't have enough facts on the circumstances of this case.
Okay, well, you are nicer than me, AB, because as far as I'm concerned, I got a big problem with the fact that you've been in 13 previous crashes. I don't care how much you out on the road. I think there are Uber drivers who have fewer collisions than this woman. You know, of course, I'd want to know the gravity of those crashes, but they did say 13 prior collisions. How do you even keep any kind of insurance with that? And also too, if you're a nurse, and I do very much appreciate the observation that you made, AB, in terms of nurses working very hard. And who knows if someone was tired, because even when I would litigate, there were times I should not have been driving without a doubt because I was so exhausted coming home very late at night or whatnot. I understand that. I get that at the same time. Also, as a nurse, you should appreciate at a time when you don't have full control over your abilities, your faculties, you know, and you shouldn't be on the road, and you should recognize the harm you could cause other people. But also, especially if you've been in 13 other crashes. Like, everything tells me that this woman had full notice and there should have been no excuse whatsoever. I honestly think I was more forgiving with the thought that she was drunk. The fact that she was sober, that scares the hell out of me. And so I understand why the DA escalated these to murder charges, because when you understand the sanctity of human life, because you're in the medical healthcare industry, as well as you understand how collisions work, because you have had 13, as far as I'm concerned, then you are a full-fledged human being who should have been 100% aware of what they're doing and the potential gravity and risk and injury to individuals you could cause. But I, and I'm sure you will too, AB, stay tuned in terms of finding out more facts about this story.